Hello everyone and welcome back to Zaklit Educational Channel. So in this video we are going to discuss the CPCB previous year's questions which came in the examination. So get ready with your notes to note down all these things, and if you haven't watched the previous videos in this session, you can watch the link given in the I button as well as in the description below. So without much delay, let's start today's video. So we are going to start from question 59 today because previous questions we have already discussed. So first question which we are going to deal today is, which convention adopted for the protection of ozone layer? So here the options are Vienna Convention, Basel Convention, Montreal Protocol or Stockholm Convention. So here students will be confused in between Vienna Convention and Montreal Protocol because they both are related to the protection of ozone layer. But if it is asked only one option you have to select, then you should select Vienna Convention because it came earlier, it came in the year 1985, it was signed, Vienna Convention in Vienna, and Montreal Protocol, it was signed in the year 1987. So these years also you should remember, I am telling you, you should note down. So these things, that is Montreal Protocol, came under the Vienna Convention. So first was Vienna Convention which was signed in 1985 in Vienna, that's why we have to select Vienna Convention as the correct option. And if you are discussing this, we should also know when Basel Convention was signed. It was signed in the year 1989. This is called as connected revision because from one question you should connect with your previous knowledge what is the answer for other option. Stockholm Convention, when it was signed? It was signed in the year 2001. So it was related to the persistent organic pollutant. So these things we should all know. 4 years you came to know from one single question and you came to know which one will be the correct option. Next, again the question came from the Basel Convention. So the question is, Basel Convention is mainly dealing with what? So it deals with what? Everybody knows, it is a very chocolate question. It deals with the hazardous waste and their disposal. Yes, this hazardous waste disposal convention, that is Basel Convention, it was signed in the year 1989 because we came to know from the previous question itself. So here 1989 it was signed, and what was the main objective of this convention? It was to prevent the movement of hazardous waste specifically from the developed country to the less developed country. So developed countries, they were disposing of all the hazardous waste into the less developed countries. So this was to be stopped. In order to stop that, regulate that, Basel Convention came into action. So this is all about Basel Convention. Next, coming to the next question. So question number 61, we will see, it is, when algae grow on surface of water, it prevents what? So I will not discuss the options, I will just tell you the concept. This concept will be based on the eutrophication process. So as the nutrients are coming into the water bodies, the algae grow and they cover the surface of water. So as a result, they prevent the access of sunlight in water. The sunlight is not able to penetrate inside the water because the algal surface, they are blocking that. So as a result, what happens is the autotrophs, those who are utilizing the sunlight, they are not able to get, and they die, as well as all other organisms, eventually they die because autotrophs provide the food. If they die, then all the food cycle will be ruptured. So this is the question related to the eutrophication they have asked indirectly. Question 62, let's see. Question 62 is, what is the cause of blue baby syndrome? So this is because of option number A, that is excess of nitrate in drinking water. So here nitrate, that is NO3 minus, it is converted to NO2 minus in water. So it happens to convert from nitrate to nitrite in water. And after that, this nitrite, it binds with hemoglobin. The blood is having hemoglobin. So that hemoglobin, it becomes what? It becomes methemoglobin. M-E-T, methemoglobin. So that is unable to carry the oxygen. So the main function of hemoglobin is to carry the oxygen. So when the methemoglobin is formed, oxygen is not carried throughout the body. As a result, blue baby syndrome takes place in the infant. सो इट इज कॉल्ड एज मेथेमोग्लोबिनेमिया और मेट हेमोग्लोबिनेमिया. इट इज फाउंड इन द इन्फेंट बेबी. आई होप यू आर एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू वाटर पोल्यूशन, इंडस्ट्रियल म्यूनिसिपल सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट्स आर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ वाट काइंड ऑफ पोल्यूशन. सो हियर इट इज आस्किंग इंडस्ट्रियल म्यूनिसिपल सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट्स आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ वाट काइंड ऑफ पोल्यूशन. सो वाटर पोल्यूशन दिस क्वेश्चन इज कमिंग फ्रॉम, इट इज ऑप्शन नंबर बी, दे आर पॉइंट सोर्स. सो दिस इज अ सिंगल पॉइंट फ्रॉम वेयर वी कैन नो फ्रॉम वेयर द पोल्यूटेंट्स आर डिस्चार्ज. सो फ्रॉम द प्लेसेस वेयर यू आर नॉट एबल टू से वेयर द पोल्यूटेंट्स इज कमिंग फ्रॉम, दोज आर नॉट पॉइंट सोर्सेस. सो दे आर डिफ्यूज सोर्स वी कैन से. सो हियर पॉइंट सोर्स, दैट मीन्स वी नो द ऑरिजिन ऑफ द पोल्यूटेंट्स वेन इट इज कमिंग एंड द ऑपोजिट इज नॉन पॉइंट सोर्स. सो हियर पॉइंट मीन्स इंडस्ट्रियल, द डिस्चार्ज पॉइंट वी नो, म्युनिसिपल सीवेज वी नो, ऑल द बिग पाइप्स विल बी देयर, दे विल बी डिस्चार्जिंग. सो एज अ रिजल्ट दे आर कॉल्ड एज पॉइंट सोर्स ऑफ पोल्यूशन फॉर द वाटर. लेट्स मूव टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 64. क्वेश्चन 64 इज होल्स आर कॉज्ड इन द डैश लेयर ऑफ द एटमोस्फियर. सो हियर इट इज अ वेरी चॉकलेट क्वेश्चन. इट इज आस्किंग अबाउट ओजोन होल. यस, ओजोन होल, इट इज फाउंड इन स्ट्रेटोस्फियर. सो ऑप्शन बी विल बी करेक्ट. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज गैस पॉइजनिंग कॉजेज मीना माता डिजीज. सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज वेरी वेरी फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क्ड इन एवरी एनवायरमेंटल साइंस एंट्रेंसेस. इट इज व्हाट? इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ मर्क्यूरी पॉइजनिंग विच कॉजेज मीना माता डिजीज. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉज एज चिस्सो मीना माता. समवेयर इट विल बी मैंशन चिस्सो मीना माता. यू शुड नोट डाउन, नोट, डोंट गेट कन्फ्यूज. कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन नंबर 66. इट इज फ्रॉम द सॉयल होराइजन. सो द क्वेश्चन इज आस्किंग how many horizons are there in soils, whether it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So horizon means, if you say the soil layers, so in horizontal way, how many layers are there in soil? Particularly, most importantly, there are majorly four kinds of horizon in soil. Option D will be correct. What are they? O, A, B and C. So this thing you should note down. What are these horizon called as? So O horizon, it is called as the leaf litter zone. I will just put the short form, leaf litter zone. A horizon, it is called as topsoil. B horizon is called as subsoil. C horizon is called as parent material. It is unconsolidated mass of rocks, they are present there. So that is parent material. It is called as parent material, the C horizon. So four important horizon in soil: leaf litter, topsoil, subsoil, parent material, O, A, B, C. Coming to the next question, what is the main reason for the acid mine drainage, whether it is dirty gold mining, groundwater, granite mining or soil erosion? So this question is for you. I am not telling, you should comment me in the comment section and tell me what is the correct option. Question number 68. Why burning waste is not an acceptable practice of solid waste management? So if you are burning our waste, it is not good for environment. Why? Because it causes several environmental issues, starting from air pollution, and those are also sometimes moving, and when the waste is burned, the sum of the leftover, it is falling on the water bodies, it is coming to the water pollution and also to the soil pollution also. So mainly it is not acceptable because it causes several environmental issues, health issues, environmental issues, animals are also affected. So, coming to the next question, question number, so these are the Hindi also, they have given the questions, same questions which we discussed already. So question number 69 is, how many key characteristics of a municipal sanitary landfills are there? So this is how many key characteristics? There are three. So note down, what are the three characteristics? I will tell you, you should note down. These are the three characteristics that distinguishes it from the open dump site. So open dump site, it is not good, it is bad for the environment. Municipal sanitary landfill, they have three important features which we know. They are the key characteristics. Number one is, solid waste is placed in a suitably selected and prepared landfill site. Number two, you should note down, वेस्ट मटेरियल स्प्रेड आउट एंड कॉम्पैक्टेड विद एप्रोप्रिएट हेवी मशीनरी. सो द वेस्ट मटेरियल इट शुड बी कॉम्पैक्टेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ मशीन्स, इट शुड बी नॉट लेफ्ट लाइक लूज मटेरियल. थर्ड इज द वेस्ट इज कवर्ड ईच डे विद अ लेयर ऑफ कॉम्पैक्टेड सॉइल. सो द सॉइल आर एडेड ऑन द लेयर्स ऑफ द वेस्ट मटेरियल. So first thing is it should be suitably selected and prepared landfill site, the solid waste should be placed. Next is it should be compacted with the help of heavy machines. And third thing is every day the waste should be covered with the layer of soil. These three things are important. Coming to the question number 70, which one of the following is the prime factor towards soil pollution? Soil erosion, floods, dumping of industrial waste or using land for irrigation? What it will be? It will be option C, dumping of industrial waste. When we are dumping the industrial waste, they are releasing toxins inside the soil. As a result, the soil is polluted and eventually it moves on to the water and pollutes everything. Coming to the next question, question number 71. Question 71 is, what is the pH range of effluent after treatment? After the water treatment, what should be the pH range? So this is the common sense question. So pH, if it is less than 7, it is acidic. So it should not be less than 7. And if it is more than 7 also, it is alkaline. It is also not suitable for the water bodies. So it should be in between a certain range, coming near the neutral value. So which option is giving that thing? Option number C. Between 6.8 to 7.8, the pH should be after the treatment of water, because all these options are giving the values which are either less than 7, which is in the acid range, or more than the alkaline range, that is more than the 7 range, that is 7.8 and 8.83. So now coming to the next question, that is NAMP. We have already made a separate video on this. It is asking what is the full form of NAMP. So here, if you have watched the video, you will be able to answer this question. So here, the correct option will be option number A, National Air Quality Monitoring Program. So this was initiated by CPCB, that's why they are asking their own program. So CPCB initiated this in the year 1984. So initially its name was not NAMP. What was its name? Its name was NAAQM. So what was the full form? The full form was National Ambient Air Quality Monitoring Program. So this was the initial name, and the name changed to NAMP, that is National Air Quality Monitoring Program. To more know about this, you can check the link in the I button. Coming to the next question, question number 73. When did the National Green Tribunal Act Institute started? So this National Green Tribunal Act, it was constituted in the year 2010. NGT. So what it is responsible for? So its duty is for the rapid disposal of cases relating to the environmental issues. So this is about NGT, to dispose of rapidly the cases which are related to environmental issues in our country. That is NGT in 2010. Coming to the next question, it is from the analytical chemistry. Question is, what is the full form of AAS? So here the correct option will be option number B, atomic absorption spectrophotometry, or it is also called as atomic absorption spectroscopy. So AAS, that is the full form, analytical chemistry. Coming to the next question, question number 75, it is, suggest suitable analytical instrument for non-volatile solute. And the options are GC, that is gas chromatography, HPLC, that is high performance liquid chromatography, both GC and HPLC, or none of them. So here, what will be the correct option? Correct option will be option number B, HPLC, that is high performance liquid chromatography. It deals with the analytical instrument for the non-volatile solute. If we are having our experiment with the volatile solute only, then we can go for gas chromatography, because it only analyzes the volatile substances, not the non-volatile one. So here option B will be correct. So I hope you have noted down all these important points which we have noted here in this video. and you can watch the playlist for complete CBCB preparation that is provided here, you as you can see. So all the best for the examination. See you guys in our next video. Till then, keep smiling and believe in yourself.